debut of competition at the Ganong Ice Arena, Gangwon 2024, these Winter Youth Olympic Games. And we have the rhythm dance, ice dancing, to get things underway. I'm Graham Bell, and I'm joined in the commentary box by Petra Bindle. So, Petra, what are we looking forward to today with the rhythm dance? It is music of the 80s.
So yeah, the music.
Inspired by the music or the... has to be released in the 1980s.
Yes, every year there is a new rhythm. And this year, like you said, the music and the feeling of the 80s, that will be fun. And of course, it has to be originally from the 80s, but of course it could be remastered. And yeah, we have this year in the juniors category a pattern dance included. So two sequences of the Rocker Foxtrot. Then we see a short lift. We see a step sequence, not touching. And then, of course, we have it every year, the twistle sequence.
So these. So yeah, so look out for some 80s songs coming up. One of the favorites for this competition, the pair from London, England. Representing Great Britain, obviously, Ashley Slater and Atul Onge Perez will be dancing to music by Run DMC. And we look forward to that later on.
There are no couples from the Junior Grand Prix finals or from the top three or the top six. But we had it yesterday already with the pairs. Sometimes it's because of the age, because the men are too old for the competition, because in the juniors category at the moment they can be up to 21. Yeah.
Yeah, so they've got very strict rules here for the Youth Olympics, and it's younger than the Junior Worlds. So that's what we've got this morning. Then coming up slightly later on today, we've got the women's solo competition.
Yes, and I'm looking forward to it because there we have the top two of the Junior Grand Prix final, and it will be exciting. And you remember yesterday, the men's singer competition, they started very strong with their short program, so hopefully we'll see the same with the women.
Yeah, Jacob Sanchez of the USA leading that competition after the short program with Adam Hagara of Slovakia in provisional silver medal position, and the local favourite, Hyung Kim of Korea. Let's have a look at the start list for today. We've got the siblings, brother and sister, Clara Vilkova and Tomas Vilcek of the Czech Republic. We'll get things underway in that first group. And as we say, it's going to be three groups of four with the British pair, Ashley Slater and Atul Onge Perez closing things out.
Yes, and I think it would be nice not just to watch them skating, but the costumes too.
Costumes will be 80s inspired.
You already see the leather jacket.
Yeah, obviously, if you're old enough to have grown up through the 80s, you'll remember the music that's going to be coming up. But I think everyone really kind of likes 80s
yes,
music, don't they?
Absolutely. Young guys, young girls, they like it too. So
yeah. In fact, the Czech pairing, the brother and sisters, the Vilcek and Vilcekova, are dancing to Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go.
And we have some Toto from Africa.
And Toto as well, Toto Africa. So that's what we've got to look forward to today. Obviously, they'll do their warm-up first, and we'll get a chance to have a look at them on the ice before they get going. So here we go, they're out onto the ice for their warm-up. And
first they're going to be presented.
Representing Czech Republic, Clara Vilkova, Tomas Vilcek.
Clara Vilcova and Tomas Vilcek She's the older one of the brother and sister combination. She's 15, he's 14. Audra's 15, Michael's 14.
Representing People's Republic of China, Tong Liu, Quan Shuoke.
And Tong Liu is 15 and Huang Shugi is 17.
Representing Italy, Zoe Bianchi, Pietro Rota.
And this is our youngest couple. Both of these skaters are 14 years old.
Look at him. He is, yeah, he's...
That's look like...
he's smaller than his sister. Maybe, no,
no, they're
sister,
not brother and sister. Partner, yeah.
Yeah, partner, yeah.
We have 5 minutes time for your warm-up.
So 5 minutes for the rhythm dance with a length of 250 plus minus 10 seconds. And it will be quite interesting to see them skating to this rhythm. So I saw, of course, in a seniors competition, I saw a couple of really nice dances this year to the music and the feeling of the 80s and at the Junior Grand Prix final too. And as they are so young, they haven't been on the ice that long together. But sometimes when I remember Tessa Rutte and Scott Moyer, so the twice Olympic champions from Canada, they started skating together with 6 years each. So very early, but that was, I would say, a kind of an exception. Normally they start a bit later skating together. And you see that, of course.
Canada 선수들은 지난 2023년 그단스크에서 열렸던 솔리데리티컵에 참가했습니다. She is our 15-year-old Canadian skater who likes drawing and skating with her is 14-year-old from Toronto, representing Canada, Audra Gans, Michael Butsan.
Audra Gans and Michael Butsan. Gans is from Quebec and Butsan from Toronto, or born in Toronto. They are dancing to Burning Down the House by Talking Heads and Should I Stay and Should I Go by The Clash. Have a look at the Chinese pair, Chinese couple. Are going to be dancing to Bronski Beat, a double by Bronski Beat, Love and Money and Why.
That was in the 80s too, Bronski Beat.
Yeah, it launched Jimmy Somerville, who then went on to be in the Communards. Yeah. Actually, with a friend of mine. Zoe Bianchi and Pietro Rota, the youngest couple, just 14 years old. And they're dancing to a favorite of mine, Blondie. Absolutely love that album, Parallel Lines. Although Rapture and Call Me was on Parallel Lines. Rapture was a little bit later. I'm in my element with 80s music. I could go on all night.
And what we have here too, of course, like in the single or so in the pairs competition, we have, of course, the technical score and the program components. And the components, I will tell you a bit more during the warm-up. It's, of course, the composition, the presentation and the skating skills. And what's included in a composition? We have multidimensional movements and the use of space. The connections between and within the elements, that's very important. Then, of course, the choreography reflecting music of phrase and form, the pattern, the ice coverage, and the unity when it comes to pairs or maybe ice dance couples on the ice. Then the presentation includes the expressiveness and the projection, the variety and the contrast of energy and the movements, the musical sensitivity and the timing, that is very important too. And then we have the skating skills with a variety of edges, steps, turns, movements, and directions. The clarity of edges, that is very important in ice dancing. The steps, the turns, the movements, and of course the body control, the balance and glide, the flow, and the power and the speed. So these are the three components. They changed it last season. Before we had five components, but from last season we have three.
So we're looking for those deep angles, aren't we, for the skating technique with a deep low knee and strong edges.
Yeah, the clarity of the edges, and especially in ice dancing, you see a lot of turns and movements. And normally they are really good skaters, the ice dancers, because they learn it very early. So we will see. But this is, of course, interesting. Normally we had a couple. It was Mary Davis, Charlie White. They won the Olympics in 2014. And he was the same age like her. So that it always, when he was on his knee, he was smaller than her. Normally we say in ice dancing, maybe 20 centimeters difference would be nice. But it's not always like that. And you know, the young boys, they are often a bit smaller and then they get taller.
Yeah, young men tend to mature a fraction later. They get that testosterone boost at around about this age, don't
they?
Yeah,
in the novice category, often the boys are smaller than the girls, yeah.
So the first couple that will take to the ice will be from Czechia. And it's the brother and sister combination.
Representing Czech Republic, Klára Vilková, Tomáš Vilček.
Klára Vilková and Tomáš Vilček, both from Brno. And they're dancing to Toto's Africa and Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go, of course, by the great George Michael and Wham.
We will see five elements in the rhythm dance. I always love this song. The first element, the twistle sequence. At least two twistles for each partner, but they show three, that's even better. And they are in the rocker foxtrot pattern, and they start with the second sequence. Here, the woman skates the man's step, and the man skates the woman's steps. And the two sections of the rocker foxtrot, they skated in any order, or one after the other, or separately. The lift, the straight line lift, with a maximum of 7 seconds. And let's start the first rocker sequence. Of course, it's the second now in the program, but they choose now the version where the men must skate the men's steps and the women's steps. We are in the step sequence. They can choose midline or diagonal. They've chosen the midline. It's a non-touching version. So what's important here, that it's skated no more than two arm lengths apart. What's allowed is touching the ice with any part of the body, but not for longer than 5 seconds. Here they don't choose that option, but they can. Oh no, yeah. At the end of the sequence.
Well, the brother and sister from Czechia have got things underway here at the Danong Ice Arena.
Republic, Klára Vilková, Tomáš Vilček.
15 and 14 years old. in their early stages of development as ice dancers.
Yeah, it's their second competition this year, or the third after the Nationals. They were part of the Paveroman Memorial. And you can see that they still need some time to feel comfortable together, because harmony is very important too. The twister sequence was quite nice, but she's a bit stiff in her upper body. She could move a bit more. Very concentrated, look in her faces.
We're not hearing the music that they actually danced to.
Normally we have it. So at the Worlds or at the ICU competitions, you normally hear the music in the slow motion. You hear from their dance, that's even better. We just hear the music that is playing in the hall. And of course then the steps, they don't fit to it, so it's like.
To get things underway. Next out onto the ice is the team from Canada.
But just look at the first steps when they are coming on the ice. There's already, the show starts before the program, and this is perfect. This is ice dancing.
So we have Audrey Gans from Quebec and Michael Boutsan from Toronto. They are skating to Burning Down the House and by Talking Heads and Should I Stay or Should I Go by The Clash.
Okay. Really nice start of the twister sequence. In sync. Very high level here of the twister sequence. Very good. Let's start the midline step sequence. Very nice speed. They've chosen the rotational lift. So you gotta let me know.
strong finish there by the Canadians.
And I think you could see the difference to the first couple.
Big difference in level there.
Yeah, big difference. And I really love the mimics because that is so important in ice dancing too. To not just be good skaters, you really have to be artists on ice too. And her smile and her mimics, and they have really good harmony together. Very good couple already in a very young age.
That's the first of two Canadian teams that will be skating today.
They competed at one Junior Grand Prix event this season in Gdansk with a 17th place in the juniors category. You see how many good couples we have worldwide in the juniors category. Of course, not all of the, I would say, edges were brilliant, but a very good sensitivity for music. And look at her face. And the twister
Rizzles,
sequence
yeah.
were really good. Really good. They fit really good together. But the Canadians, of course, they are very well known for good ice dancers. I already mentioned twice Olympic champions, Tessa Virtue, Scott Moyer. They have others too.
And this is the next generation.
Yes, and we have in Canada, we have this big ice dance school in Montreal, so where all of the skaters, so the best couples from all over the world are, yeah, be trained.
Audra and Michael are just starting out their performance pathway, their career pathway in this sport.
Oh, and look at this.
That's a good score, 52.99.
So after the 33 for the first couple, great.
Yeah, they're stoked.
That's a big difference between the first two couples.
Well, we saw that.
Ah, big heart for us. We take it.
So the third couple out onto the ice from the People's Republic of China. Tong Liu and Huang Shouji, both from Harbin. 15 and 17. And they will be skating to Bronski Beat, Love and Money and Why.
It's their first big international competition.
Thank you. Nice finish there by the couple from the People's Republic of China, dancing to Bronski Beat, the band that launched Jimmy Somerville.
And he seems to, I would say, to be a great ice dancer. Yes, all of the abilities that a good ice dancer needs. She was very focused, you see it in her face. Very concentrated, of course. It's the Youth Olympics. They are young and they're allowed to compete. And
they're 15, she is 17. He is. And so they've had slightly more experience, but not on that international stage.
Yeah.
It's their first international competition.
Yes. That is huge. Look at the audience again here in this ice rink. It was a solid performance. I would say should be in second place now with this rhythm dance.
There's quite a big gap, though, isn't there?
Yes.
52 to 33.
Yeah, we have almost 20 points. This is huge in ice dancing. 20 points.
Nervous wait for the scores.
Yeah, very close.
50.92. So just slotting in behind the Canadian pair. Only a couple of points behind.
Yeah. The last couple of this group is on the ice, the Italians.
Yeah, Zoe Bianchi and Pietro Rota, both 14 years old, the youngest pair in the competition. They're going to be skating to a favourite of mine, Blondie. She saw Debbie Harry performing at the Isle of Wight Festival this year, and she's still going strong, I can tell you.
very concentrated, not completely in sync with the twist or sequence. It's not easy. And the last element of this rhythm dance, the midline step sequence.
Well, both still very young, 14 years old, and what an experience to skate here at these Youth Olympic Games. There were some technical problems that I'm sure you will point out, Petra.
Yeah.
But what do you think of the overall feel that the move that they did in the middle, that lift, that was quite interesting.
It was amazing. And I love his skating, so he already has a really nice posture on the ice. And the Italians are very well known for good ice dancing. Charlene Guignard, Marco Fabbri, they won 2 weeks ago, they won for the second time the European Championships, and they are amazing. So they have good coaches in Italy for ice dancing. They have some synchro problems in the twistles. We saw it in the midline step sequence. Maybe we see it again now in the slow motion.
Yeah, so let's have a look at the replays.
But this is nice. So the mimics, of course, very good. And look at his posture here. And the pattern, one of the two Rocker Foxtrot sequences. And this was the lift. This was great. A straight line lift. Very amazing. Not that easy. You see the twistles you see here, that they are not completely in sync. You have, of course, different levels. You have four levels for the twistles too. It was fun seeing them skating together. The last couple of the first group.
Yeah, so we wait for the scores.
And here they are. That's okay. That's absolutely okay. Around 40.
Yeah, third place.
Zoe Bianchi and Pietro Rota of
Italy. Coached there by Federica Bernardi.
5 points, so which brings them former to third place.
Absolutely okay.
So that wraps up the first group with the Canadians. 2 point lead over the team from the People's Republic of China, with the young Italians in third and the brother and sister Czech pair in fourth place. So we're going to run through with group two. We've got Canadian team, team from Ukraine, team from Germany, and a second team from the Czech Republic. Let's introduce them to the crowd.
Representing Canada, Caroline Kravitz, Jacob Starr. Representing Ukraine, Sofia Rakunova, Denis Fedyukin. Okay.
representing Germany, Mieli Meyer, David Calderari. 체코공화국 선수들입니다. Representing Czech Republic, Andrea Serna, Yakim Nova. 지금부터 선수들은 5분 동안 웜업 시간을 갖도록 하겠습니다. Skaters, you have 5 minutes time for your warm-up.
So we've got 5 minutes warm-up of this second group. And if you look at the first couple, the Canadians, both from Kitchener in Ontario, they're going to be skating to Human by the Human League and People Are People by Depeche Mode.
Human is one of my, I would say, overall favorite songs. Really. Looking forward to seeing what they are doing on the ice. Canadians, like said in the first group, very well known for ice dancing.
The team from Ukraine, both from Kyiv, will be skating to Under Pressure by Queen and David Bowie and Purple Rain by Prince.
Prince, wow.
Sofia Rakunova, Denis Fadienke.
And the German pair.
ISU Junior Grand Prix, Budapest Cup에서 참가한 바 있습니다.
Mieli Meyer from Landsberg am Lech, hometown Oberstdorf.
Yeah.
And Davide Calderardi, originally born in Lugano, but now lives in Oberstdorf.
The Oberstdorf is, I would say, the main center for figure skating in Germany.
And they've got a three-way combination. They're going Mad World, Tears for Fears, One Night in Bangkok, do you remember that track? And Another One Bites the Dust by Queen. And the second pair from the Czech Republic, from Prague.
They have three songs too.
Andrea Serna, Yakim Nova.
Yeah, Andrea Serna and Yakim Novak, they're dancing to Black Velvet by Alana Miles. Remember that one? What's Love Got to Do With It by Tina Turner and Living on a Prayer by Bon Jovi.
Nice mix too.
Yeah, that's going to kind of ramp up, that is. Starts with Black Velvet and then it'll be ending with a big finish with Bon Jovi. Yakim Novak lists his hobbies as skiing, mountain biking and eating. Not sure if eating can necessarily qualify as a hobby. Kind of a necessity.
Yeah. The Czech team here in this group definitely has the most experience in competing. It's already their sixth competition this season, so quite interested to watch what they will show us here in the rhythm dance.
Yeah, so Czechia earned two spots due to the performance at the World Juniors. That was the way it works out. And I'm not sure if that shirt looks entirely 80s. I think that's more 70s.
Yes, it's very colourful here, yeah, especially his shirt. But I think it must be a lot of fun for the young skaters to skate to your music. But maybe with the music of their parents.
Skaters, there is 1 minute left in this warm-up.
So we're about a minute away from, actually 40 seconds. I just saw the clock there ticking down for the warm-up. Ooh, they've got a,
yeah.
They've got a good
yeah,
lift.
Yeah, and I love, I love the outfit too, so I loved it.
practicing the twizzles.
Yeah, just two of them. They just have to show a set of two twizzles, but of course when they show a set of three, then the level is higher. And when the leg is straightened, for example, or we see sometimes twizzles in a kind of a seated position too, then it's even more complicated and gets a higher level and more GOE, so the grade of execution, so when it goes down to plus four.
So from Canada, it's Caroline Kravets and Jacob Stark.
Caroline Kravets, Jacob Stark.
And they will be dancing to Human by the Human League and People Are People by Depeche Mode.
Coming in with two 12th places this season, a 12th place in the Canadian Champion Junior Championships and the Junior Grand Prix in Budapest. The first couple now in this competition, he shows the two section of the Rocker Foxtrot directly after the other, not just separately. And they started with the first sequence and then the second sequence. The other couples always started with the second sequence where the men skates the women steps and the women the men steps.
Well, they started strongly with that lift.
Yeah, stationary lift, the first time we saw it in this competition.
Representing Canada, Caroline Kravets, Jacob Stark.
Yeah, what's missing here is the speed. You saw it in the twistle sequence. That was really slow, especially the second part of the twistles. They just show a set of two twistles. The others we normally a set of three. Then the level, of course, is lower.
Yeah.
So let's have a look. Yeah, the first stationary lift of the competition. We've already seen rotational lifts and straight line lifts. But that was really nice at the beginning. Good start of this rhythm dance.
Good strength there from Jacob. He's 18, so he's slightly more developed than some of the other couples that we've seen physically.
What I was missing was her mimics to the music. She was really concentrated on her steps, on what she was doing, on the eyes. Here you see kind of a face expression, but when she was inside of the pattern, she was very focused.
It's weird not having the music that they skated to. You've got AC/DC playing instead.
Yeah, since I don't like it in the slow motion. Normally, I would love to hear the music again. So, at the moment, we have a range between 33 points and 52 within the first four couples.
There'll be somewhere between that.
Yes.
It's a huge range.
Yeah,
they'll definitely be in the... Well, we'll see.
Definitely not in the top two. I would say maybe fourth place. No, it's third place.
47.98 goes into third place.
Caroline Kravitz and Jacob Stark of Canada has earned 47.
So Canada lead. Canada now in third. So they're happy with that. They'll take it. That's good to see. Good to hear.
Representing Ukraine, Sofia Rekhanova, Denis Fedenkin.
Sofia Rekhanova and Denis Fedenkin of Ukraine, both from Kyiv. And they will be dancing to Under Pressure by Queen and David Bowie and Purple Rain by Prince.
And they start with the first sequence of the Rocker Foxtrot.
Thank you. Sofia Rekunova and Denis Fedenkin from Ukraine. Well, 15 years old.
Representing Ukraine. And you could see they had a lot of problems and struggled a lot here in this rhythm dance. It seems that they are quite new to ice dancing.
But a great experience,
of course,
for the team from Ukraine.
Really amazing for them, of course, to compete here in Gangwon. But both had the same problem, I think, especially in the upper body, very stiff, both of them.
And we were talking about the edge angles.
Yes,
as well,
that too. Not a good clarity here in the etching. And what's really missing is this gliding over the ice with a deep knee. And she lost a lot of speed during the twistle sequence. And here at the end, she struggled a bit.
Yeah, just a slight loss of balance.
Straight line lift here.
Well, they're happy enough to be here.
Yes, of course. It's an amazing experience. Ever can say I was at the Youth Olympics. Oh, how lovely is that?
.76 puts into fifth place, just ahead of the couple from the Czech Republic.
But it's okay. It's absolutely okay. And now I'm excited, of course, the German couple is about to skate.
Representing Germany, Mia Lee Meyer, David Calderati.
Mia Lee Meyer and Davide Calderati will be skating to Mad World by Tears for Fears, One Night in Bangkok, and Another One Bites the Dust by Queen.
And they are in the Rocker Foxtrot second sequence. And what is very important for this pattern is that we have in each of the sequences four key points. And the key point is correctly executed when Alex-related key point features are met and Alex etches or steps are held for the required number of beats.
The ultimate test, cerebral fitness. finishing with the rotational lift. And the team from Germany.
Representing Germany.
Good choreography, good use of the expression there.
Yeah, absolutely.
You can see that they had the good skating skills.
They were in fourth place at the National Junior Championships and came strong here to Gangwon with a third place at the Dennis Tan Memorial in Astana. The young couple from Germany. I love the mix of the music.
Yeah, they didn't do... It said they were going to do Mad World, but no. It was One Night in Bangkok and Another One Bites the Dust. Mia Lee Meyer, just 15 years old.
Train around 16 hours a week in Oberstdorf. I remember when I spent a lot of time in Oberstdorf during summer.
Calder Ari, 17.
It was a nice one, the rotational lift. And when we have the free dance, then we sometimes see a combination lift. So can choose a combination or two single lifts.
Yeah, big finish.
The scores, please.
This is good. This is good.
52 is the lead, and it's 50.57. It's only just behind.
It's a personal best for them.
Yes, it puts them in third place, just behind the Chinese pair Tong Lui and Guanshan Ji.
Representing Czech Republic, Andrea Cerna, Jakim Novak.
Andrea Cerna and Jakim Novak from the Czech Republic. Now, the music I've got down is Black Velvet, What's Love Got to Do with It by Tina Turner, and Living on a Prayer by Bon Jovi. Start with Black Velvet by Alana Miles.
Really nice twistles. Good start. Very nice lift.
Keep
So the last element of this rhythm dance, the midline step sequence. We haven't seen a diagonal step sequence so far. All of the couples choose the midline sequence.
Excellent stuff there from Andrea Paterna and Jakim Novak. That took it to another level. Really did for me.
Yes, I loved it. And we already talked about in the warm-up that we say, okay, this couple, that could be really good. When we just saw the lift at that time and they did an excellent job. And you really see they have a good harmony.
Well, she's 16, he's 17. They've got some real experience there. And
yes.
It's starting to really come through. Straight line lift was excellent.
Very nice couple together. There's a height difference, a bit too much maybe for ice dancing, but you don't see it when they are skating, and that's good. It was really a nice, lovely skate from the two. And like said before, they have a lot of experience already on an international level. Skated at both of the Grand Prix events, so in Istanbul and Gdansk, there were six, of course. Not enough to compete in the final, but
you saw it with the twizzles, didn't you? It was a different level.
Yes, and a nice speed too here in the twizzle sequence. Very good pusher here within the pattern sequences. And this was really good. The lift. A lot of variations of her. Now I'm quite curious about the scores.
Well, it's going to be up there. Is it the lead? Current leader is the team from Canada, Andrea Gans and Michael Bootson, with 52.99.
And a very
beautiful
couple.
They would need a personal best
yes.
to take the lead.
What we've seen. And it's not a personal best.
Not quite.
Yeah.
It was up there. Second place for the team from the Czech Republic.
Yeah.
I think they'll take that. They're pretty happy with that.
And now we have another break.
So, yeah, we have a break and we can look at the scores. And, yeah, we did say it's 52.99 for Gans and Bootsen, with Cerna and Novak going in just behind, and the People's Republic of China in third.
So four couples at the moment over 50 points. So it's very close. And we will have one more group. They are on the ice now.
And they will be introduced to the crowd here in the Gangwon Ice Arena that is growing steadily as this competition goes on.
United States of America, Olivia Illin, Dylan Kane.
Olivia Illin and Dylan Kane.
Representing Republic of Korea. Kim Jimmy, Lee Namu, 대한민국 선수들입니다. Representing France, Andre Perrier Giassini, Samuel Wong Clapperman. 영국 선수들입니다. Representing Great Britain, Ashley Slatter, Atalange Perez.
And a team from Great Britain. Ashley Slatter and Atalange Perez, one of the favourites going into this as we go into the five-minute warm-up. So go through the teams.
Quite big competition here at the Youth Olympics. That's good for the ice dancing.
The Americans are very young. She's 14, he's 15.
But not the youngest couple we've seen today.
No, that was the Italians. They were both 14.
They had a really good result at the Junior Grand Prix in Istanbul with the sixth place in the juniors category.
They had a Greece program which was filmed by On Ice Perspective. It went viral last year.
And I'm really looking forward because they choose music now for the rhythm dance from the Pointer Sisters. It would be nice.
Yeah. Kim and Lee from Korea, both 16.
Republic of Korea.
They've got experience on the junior world stage.
Yes. Now all of the couples here in this last group, they have quite a nice international experience.
Yeah, Kim and Lee won a bronze medal at the Junior Grand Prix in Thailand.
These skaters are both 16 years of age, ranked fifth place at the 2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix
and
in Istanbul.
Ombre Perrier, Gaisini, and Samuel Bon Clapperman. It's a shame for France because they've only got one spot available at the Youth Olympic Games this year because they've actually got two teams that are very good at this age. But Amber and Samuel got it.
This is nice, this rotational lift. I love it.
He likes Eastern philosophies and culture. Representing Great Britain, Ashley Slatter, Ethel Onge Perez.
Ashley Slatter and Ethel Onge Perez. They come into this with the highest PB and certainly one of the favourites for a podium.
But look at all the PBs now in this group. They are all over 53, 54, 55 points. Normally they should be though in the first four places, but yesterday we saw the men's competition, how quick it goes. That's the big favourite then. Yeah, I would say it was not his best day yesterday, of course, and he was so sad and we were almost crying with him, little boy from Japan.
Yeah. Well, it's great to see British ice dancing coming back after the glory days of Torvald and Dean.
We had another couple in between, so years ago they were third at the Euros. They were really good.
The
brother and sister combination, yeah.
We've now got Lila Fear and Lewis Gibson competing well at European Championships and World Championships.
And as we have a French couple here, of course, I think everyone remembers Gabriela Papadakis, Guillaume Cicéron. They never said that they are done with figure skating after their win at the Olympics in Beijing 2 years ago. They said, okay, we need a break now, and maybe they'll come back for 2026, we see. That's what Tessa Virtue and Scott Moyer did. We're out of competition for 2 years, came back strong, and then they won in 2018 here on this ice.
Skaters, there is 1 minute left in this warm-up.
So 1 minute left, and we can look forward to a bit of music choices. The Americans are going for a Pointer Sisters three-way combination. Neutron Dance, I Need You, and I'm So Excited. That's probably the biggest hit from the Pointer Sisters. And the Korean team will be I Love Rock and Roll by Joan Jett and All She Wants to Do Is Dance by Don Henley. You don't really associate Don Henley with 80s music, but we have another Pointer Sisters by the French team. I Need You and I'm So Excited. So we're going to hear I'm So Excited twice, and that will definitely make us very excited.
So we can dance here too, and Graham, so we can have a lot of fun.
And the Brits, well, it's Run DMC, personal favourite of mine. Of course, It's Tricky, and then Walk This Way, featuring Aerosmith. They're great. Steve Tyler. One of the biggest showmen in rock and roll.
You know, this warm-up was really good. What we've seen here so far. Will be nice, this last group.
So four teams left, and it's the young American couple that will get things underway.
And what we will see here is the first curve lift of the competition.
Representing United States of America, Olivia Illen, Dylan Kane.
Olivia Illen and Dylan Kane. And we're going to have music by the Pointer Sisters.
Yes, first part of the Pointer Sisters.
Big moment for this young couple.
Very good start, really lovely twist of sequence at the beginning of the rhythm dance. And they're in their first rocker foxtrot sequence. That was a lovely skate here, and she's really happy with the performance of
yes.
the rhythm dance.
Yeah. And a young pair there.
Yeah.
Obviously, the boy Dylan doesn't have the physical development
yes.
of some of the other couples, so we didn't see the big lifts, but there's definitely some skating skills there and a good choice of music and great choreography. Whenever I hear that neutron dance, it always makes me think of Beverly Hills Cop. So it's definitely invoking that 80s spirit.
Yeah. And like we talked about during the program, it's always interesting to see already the difference between a 15-year-old boy and a 17-year-old boy. So especially when it comes to the height.
And the physicality.
Yes. Yeah. But they look really cute together on the ice. And I really love the twister sequence at the beginning. That was a very strong one, high level. And she is so happy. Look at her already at the beginning of the program. Nice mimics. And this was very strong, especially the first sequence of the twistles.
Yeah, with the leg lifted like that.
That gets, of course, higher GOEs when you're doing this. And here the curve lift.
Well, hides to back home. Now time for the scores.
Their personal best of 53.74, and that is a new PB, and it's a really good new PB.
Lead. That is the lead. 57.46.
That is amazing. Congrats to this young couple from the USA.
So young, and they have now gone into gold medal position.
Now it's getting loud, Graham.
The People's Republic of Korea. Ginny Kim and Namu Lee will be skating to I Love Rock and Roll by Joan Jett and the Blackhearts. And All She Wants to Do is Dance by Don Henley. They're going to get the support of the crowd.
And they have a personal best of 56.3.
Well, big rotational lift to finish. Got a huge round of applause by this local crowd. It's interesting, the music, though, Joan Jett and the Blackhearts, I would have always associated with the 1970s, although it did come out in 81. It's more of that kind of punk vibe.
Yes, yes.
And Donna Henley's All She Wants to Do Is Dance was used in Coyote Ugly, the film Coyote Ugly. So not classic 80s kind of memories.
Yeah.
It didn't bring back 80s feeling for me, the music choice. But the performance was great.
The performance was really good. And it's so amazing that these young athletes got that amazing support by a big crowd here in this arena.
And lots of mascots.
And of course, completely different to the couple we saw before. But this is good. And you already mentioned in the warm-up that they had a third place at the Junior Grand Prix in Bangkok this season. Very strong. And then a 10th in Osaka. That's why they couldn't qualify for the final at the end in Beijing.
So they have a personal best of 56.30. They would need to better that by a point and and change to go into the lead.
Yeah, they would need a personal best to get in the lead. The first part of the twistles. And the second, they were not completely in sync. I would say that we will now see a change in lead. But we were surprised yesterday.
Yeah, hold on.
Yes, I think.
This is the local pair as well.
Yeah, but I think because maybe this little error here in the twistle sequence and the other ones were perfect. But of course, a very strong performance.
So time for the scores to come through for Ginny Kim and Namu Lee.
Aaron Love, the coach of the two, is with them.
Say hi to Hojung.
Here we go with the scores.
Jin Kim and Namu Lee representing Republic of Korea.
Second place. 56.58.
And it's a PB. That's good.
It is a PB, and they are just under a point behind the leaders.
That's great.
So very much in touch.
It's very close now at the top of a ranking. Two more couples to come.
Yeah, two to come. We start with the French.
Andre Perrier, Gianna Sini, Samuel
And Ombre Perrier, Giannassini, and Samuel Blanc Clapperman will be giving us some more point assisters. We'll be right back. Well, lovely rotational lift to finish. But there was a moment there where heart in the mouth. I almost thought they were going to go into the onto the boards.
Yeah, that was the end of the midline step sequence.
The French pair from Lyon.
A very major performance already, and they both are 16. Okay, she is close to her 17th birthday, and she will have a birthday here at the Youth Olympics on the 31st of January.
And he's very physically developed.
Already for 16 years.
16 years
because
old.
Because we saw this young guy with 15 and when...
Well, that's the great thing about the Youth Olympics. It's about development, isn't it?
Yes. They look really cute together on the ice, the couple from France.
Well, they're well matched, aren't they?
Yes. Had a first place at the Santa Claus Cup in Budapest. Two strong performances at the Junior Grand Prix with two fifth places in Linz and in Istanbul. This was really nice here. The twistles, very high level. It would be nice just to see, like we have at the ISU competitions, to see the yes and the no's, the key points, if they executed them or not during their pattern sequences.
That was where the music
this
changed
was, yeah.
to...
I'm so excited. And this was really good at the end, the rotational lift to finish their rhythm dance.
Well, the leaders are the American couple, Olivia Illin and Dylan Kane.
This couple has a personal best of 55.04 from the Grand Prix competition in Austria. Wow, look at that.
The first place, 62.39.
This is amazing. That's 7 points over the PB from Linz. And look at his face. She's smiling and I think...
He's a little bit kind of, wow, did we just
do
that?
What's going on here, yeah?
Did we just do that? Yes, they did indeed. They've taken the lead by a big margin.
He's really cool.
So the last couple to take to the ice... Ashley Slatter and Atil Onge Perez. They will be skating to a Run DMC couple of songs. It's Tricky and Walk This Way. This is my recital. I think it's very vital. To back around, that's right. On top. It's Tricky.
Oh, this is bad for the first fall of the competition.
Oh dear,
this is really, really bad. Hopefully they can... Yeah, that's the right answer. That's what I wanted to say, that they give the right answer after this fall with a strong rotational lift.
Love it. Well, a big finish with the Trizzles. But there was that stumble. And Petra, you did mention this is now the 12th couple that are on the ice.
Yes. And
sometimes you do get, it's the worst ice conditions.
Yes. Normally you say, okay, 12 skaters is fine. Then you have to need, then you need an ice resurfacing. And we had 3 warm-ups of 5 minutes. We had 12 couples on the ice with a maximum of 250. And I think it's always complicated as a skater. I love to skate at last, but we have already have a lot of holes on the ice. Not that much, man, maybe when you see the single skating with the jumps. But of course, the ice is not that good anymore. Maybe that was the reason for the fall. Let's see when we maybe, hopefully we see the element again in the slow motion. Maybe it was just a little mistake. It went so fast.
But otherwise, performance
was
good.
Great.
And
yes,
the routine good.
The choice of the music and the outfit differently to the others, but I loved it.
Yeah, it looks proper 80s.
And of course, it came in so strong with a PB of 56.75 points. But this is, these things happen to the best skaters too. This was strong. That was a really good answer. We don't see it anymore. No. They don't show it. And he was great. It mimics. They really were in the moment.
Yeah, very strong.
Yes, and that's why I would say normally they would have
be challenging for
the
lead.
Top three, yes,
yeah,
of course,
challenging
yeah.
for the lead.
Definitely. So now it's interesting because we just know after the skate about the key points of the patterns. But they should get high components, but of course the deduction for the fall. This is nice, they are still smiling, and this is good. This is really lovely.
Here we go. Seventh place, 50.91. Well, there's a lot of skating couples in that 50 range, and you see the 1 point yeah. deduction for the fall. Ashley Slatter and Atal Onge Perez. Well, they're still in touch.
Yeah, it will be difficult in ice dancing. It's not that easy
to move up into the medals. So you can see there's a clear leader, the French couple, a 62.39 with Ilin and Kane.
Just ahead of the
America.
German couple here.
Yeah.
Mialli so, Meyer and Davide Calderari.
It's looking good.
Yeah.
For the. This is the results from the rhythm dance.
We saw some really strong performances, especially in the last group.
Yeah, so what have we got to look forward to? Well, coming up later in the ice rink here in Ganong, we've got the women's solo competition. I hope you'll join us then. But if you've enjoyed the rhythm dance, then tune in a couple of days' time. We've got the free dance of the ice dancing here at the Youth Olympic Games. Join us then.
모두 퇴장을 부탁드립니다. 퇴장 후 재검토가 있겠습니다.